is that so much of what we have seen in movies and television are symbols. Are you aware that that I have been talking to some doctors in Los Angeles who have been doing some research on this, and I find it to be absolutely fascinating that many of the gangs, the Latino and the black gangs in the major cities across America, their graffiti that they are spraying on buildings, their graffiti are actually Masonic emblems and Masonic seals and symbols. And I have seen a whole collection that these doctors have. These are medical doctors, but they are interested in this subject. And they have been collecting hundreds of pictures of graffiti and showing the research into the ancient secret societies. And there's no way that these black and Latino gangs could know these symbols. There's definitely a connection between the gangs and some sort of a higher orchestrated mind behind the warfare going on between gangs.
And now I've got older and, you know, I'm wiser now, and I've been looking around and stuff, and I started investigating the New World Order and the Illuminati, and I gotta tell you, man, there's some strong similarities between the two. It almost makes me think that the Illuminati runs the gang system of America.
The Bloods and the Crips, okay? You gotta understand something, people. This whole idea came from the kingdom of hell. It came from Satan, fallen angels, demons and spirits. The whole idea did not come from the guys who started up the Bloods and the Crips. That didn't come from them. That did not come from them. They got that from Satan. And he put the idea in their minds and in their hearts. Okay, that whole thing comes from the kingdom of darkness, man. And when every time Satan sees you, he sees all of your sins following you around, man. He sees all of your sins and your past sins following you around, tormenting your mind and haunting you. Why? Because you are not covered in Jesus' blood. So understand this. Satan knows how serious the blood is concerning with God, okay? He knows how serious the blood is. Even the witches know how serious the blood is, okay? Evil witches uses people's blood to put curses and spells on them.
The York Rite, which we can see here, has 13 degrees, or 13 steps, or 13 levels. And the Scottish Rite, as we can see here, has 33 degrees. This is very interesting because two of the main Hispanic gangs, Mara Salvatrucha, or MS-13, and Sureño 13, both have 13 as their signifying number. And Trey Trey Crips, one of the bigger Crip gangs, uses 33 as its signifying number. So in other words, as you can see here, the Latin Kings, another really big street gang, they use the devil horns to signify their gang. Also, they use the crown, which anybody who studies the Illuminati knows that the crown represents the sun or its sun worship.
Then I look at a lot of the symbols with the gang, Fathers, disciples, and the people.
I need to know, man. So tell me, brother. Killing each other for
colors,
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 colors.
We killing each other over curses.
And a lot of them comes from the Mason doctrine, and it really gets me. Some of the laws is in the Mason's rule book. So, I mean, it's good enough to say that BGD was started by Freemasons.
Are you a Blood or are you a Crip?
Or are you just stupid? I just want to be 100. First of all, I do mess with you. However, you guys are being bamboozled, played, all of that. I know some of y'all know, but some of y'all still doing it. Y'all still killing each other instead of working together like a team should be.
They're taking y'all and y'all is segregating y'all for reasons that y'all can see, but y'all can't see because of that one dude in your circle who's saying, "Nah, F that, I'm this. And if that nigga come here, I'm clapping him." And then the suckers behind him be like, Damn, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because they want to be so tough and all of this.
Y'all got to take the moment and listen, because you got the Bloods and the Crips. You got the red and the blue. You got the Democrats and the Republicans. This is deeper than that. They doing what they want y'all to do. You know what I'm saying? The Illuminati is completely controlling y'all. And y'all don't even see that shit. You think about it. They playing chess right now, and the pieces are y'all. You don't pay attention, yo. Bloods and the Crips. It's murder rates out there. It's the team winning right now. Y'all still letting them play with y'all lives, and then y'all OGs out there, y'all let the little ones go do the same thing. Stop letting these people use y'all. They taking you Bloods and Crips, and they promoting y'all on television to make more violence, create more of that, this, that, and the third. And this is what's happening. And now it's going to the point where they starting to not need y'all, because they got YouTube and social media and rappers like Chirac to promote all that gun and stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's another video game. It's another whole another video game right there. Because they don't want y'all sticking together. But y'all keep signing up for this Bloods and Crips thing. Y'all may as well sign up for Democrat or Republican and call it a day and do the peace civil war. Because they using y'all to smoke each other.
Burn in hell for all eternity. Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary for your sin. He wants you to repent. He wants you to turn to him. Oh, you know what that'll take? That'll take something you don't have, Crip. It'll take humility. It'll be a lack of pride. It'll be getting on your knees and begging God to forgive you. It's not a joke. This tough guy stuff is garbage. You need to repent.
Someone with an awful lot of money, an awful lot of organization, and absolute ability to provide 100% protection is supplying these city gangs. It's not the mafia.
You can bet on.
This is a very sophisticated, a totally protected organization.
Absolutely. As a matter of fact, the San Francisco Chronicle had two full pages in one of their newspapers I still have, where they were talking about how this federal government was bringing in narcotics from Asia during the Vietnam War in the bodies of American servicemen that were being killed in Vietnam, and they were bringing in bags of pure heroin and pure narcotics from Asia in the bodies of American servicemen. And what were they doing with it? They were giving it directly to the mafia, because the mafia is doing a little tricks for the government. It takes care of business for the government, so they have to be paid.
Well, let's clarify one thing here. It's not the government. It is the secret societies who are
operating behind our government.
That's correct.
Exactly.
Behind the veil of national security.
Yeah.
And I might remind you that back in history, when Albert Pike and Giuseppe Mazzini were corresponding and were setting up the core foundation of the Illuminati within Freemasonry, both in their respective countries, and at that time, of course, Albert Pike was the Grand Commander of Freemasonry throughout the world, and Giuseppe Mazzini was his counterpart in Europe on a lower level. It was Giuseppe Mazzini who created and fostered and gave the charter to the what is now known as the mafia.
That's right. La Cosa Nostra was Mazzini.
That's correct.
Masonic order.
That
no
is
doubt
right.
About it.
And this explains the close cooperation between
government and the mafia.
That is right.
Let me tell y'all something, man. All gangs fall under the Masonic code. And the Masonic code, of course, falls under Lucifer. Why you think they both have pyramids? Why you think they both have G's? Nothing is created with this much influence without a very wealthy outside source controlling it all. To the master Zionists who set it all up, to them, division is the best form of control. Let's take it to the Bible for a second. What started the so-called beef between the tribes under God's rulership? It was the division that the Jordan River made between them. Reuben, Gad, and the half-tribe of Manasseh were on the right, and the rest were on the left. All this leftist, rightist stuff is a play on how God's people began to crumble in the Word of God after being divided by the Jordan River. See, in the NBA and the NFL, the Eastern Conference is what? Blue. And Western Conference is what? Red. And when you hear these announcers talking about the East versus the West, they are only mocking the start of the fall of God's chosen people in the Word.
The West controls and Westbrook of the Thunder moves it across.
Then you have the Democrats and Republicans, they go at it, and on the lower level we have the Bloods and Crips. Don't you see the wicked design to keep separation at every level so that the people as a whole will never come together? They give you the Hollywood story that gangs were created to keep security in the hoods.
They stick together, believe me, but they protect the neighborhood more so now than ever. And which the reason they protect it now is so many empty buildings. It's so many, you know, people can go in to attack you.
But I'm here to tell you that they were created to do just what they are doing today and have always done, and that is to divide. I'm telling you all, a lot of your sheriffs, deputies, and regular patrol officers are high-ranked gang members, and they themselves do a lot of these killings that you hear about on the news. They either do them directly themselves, or they set it up so the gang they want to win the war wins. Now, everyone has their different reasons for joining these gangs. Think, how can bottom feeders create an entire book of so-called knowledge for a gang? Create the attire that they wear, create the hand signs, and then go around and recruit. All this energy, money, time, and resources could have been used to revamp the entire city and really make a change. The gang members, they also do favors for the mayors, the governors, and other heads up the pyramid.
What you wanna do? You know what you gotta do. What you want me to do, snitch him?
And to the young adults out there, don't follow these social media clowns on the net who flash money and promote a gang lifestyle, man. Most of them are agents working under the police umbrella of their city. They are put out there to make it look cool to you so that you follow the trend and immediately you'll be lost in a world of darkness. And to those who may have fell victim to a gang and joined in, I want you to know that life is about progression. Life is like a garden. We are trees that can be uprooted and regrown. You can be renewed, transformed, made a new creature. All you have to do is believe. Confess with your mouth that you have sinned and turn away from your sin through God and ask for forgiveness and walk your walk. A walk that doesn't include dying without a cause. A life where God will never desert you. A walk where you will no longer be signified by color, but rather the quality of your spirit. So drop the false flag and pick up the sword, the Bible, which is real. Break the curse of the enemy by way of the Holy Spirit and finally begin to live your life. And with the power of God, I touch and agree in spirit with you that starting this day, you are saved. Amen.